So, back for round 7 of the Rose Tower Open, and I am tired. It is already over an hour past my normal bedtime. I hope I win so I don't have to play the final round. This team looks awkward. So knowing he's got the Raichu, if I take care of the Raichu, Dracozolt is just amazing. So I need to take care of the Raichu. Take care of the Raichu when the Dracozolt in the bank. I am tired. It's not even 11 o'clock. I'm such an adult. And what even is this? I just hope this is a 2-0. Even if he ends up beating me, I hope it doesn't go to a game 3. Why am I so fuzzy? Hello? There we go. I'm probably not going to be talking much. Like, I'm way more tired than I should be at this time. But I'm such an adult. I need to focus. That's not what I want to see. He's going to Starfall. Let's get a Starfall. Probably gonna Volt Switch himself as well. It's like 3 candidates for the weakness policy on this team. Corviknight, Macross, and Togekiss. That's why I don't want to set Gravity, so I can still Hypnosis the Togekiss. He just Volt Tackles me, then that's very bad. Yeah, Excadrill is still looking pretty good. Yeah, he did Volt Switch himself. Into Clefable, please. It's a shame I didn't set Gravity, because Gravity is another way of beating the Corviknight, and especially around the Lightning Rod. But then I wouldn't be able to Hypnosis the Togekiss. Is this KO Milotic? Didn't think it would. No, it's acceptable. Big damage. It's actually very respectable. Alright, 80%, let's go. Iron Defense is here, that's actually not so bad because I get to put it in sleep. Medicine Slash. Come on, 80%. For me to go to sleep, come on. Alright, did this bulk up my defense? That means it's probably not Body Press, which frees up Excadrill a bit. Okay, good. scared of Lunbury on the Corviknight, like, because weakness policy was on the Togekiss, so it's probably like play Lapras and Lunbury Corviknight. I just pumped up again. Okay with that. Except the gravity extra drill can hit it, but I can't sweep things anymore. But I need extra drill to be able to hit it. Okay, this was a good turn. Burn Lunbury before the night. No, I can't do it this turn, I need to do it next turn. Here, my Clefable! What are you doing? At least I stalled out the Mystic Terrain, to be fair. Good drop. Why am I going with such a strategy that takes such a long time? Turns of gravity. Two turns. Let's hit it while I can. Ideally, he body presses me. Oh, that's pretty good. Do I keep my Milotic? I'm okay with that. Very good damage. Not in range of Muddy Water, most likely, but very good damage. Strong Milotic. Oh, it was strong! Sick! Sigil is looking very good here. And it was just before that happened. So I need to wake up this turn. Do I? I don't think I do. Sorry, I need Togi to stay asleep this time, but I don't. I can just get my weakness point. Okay, I'm prepared. So I just win. Leftovers was a good item in this game. Should I reveal Rockfall? I think I will, just to ensure I win. And I don't reveal my final Pokemon as well. Unless he wakes up and Drain Punch KOs with a crit. Oh, that did good damage. So that's probably Assault Vest with like defensive investment. I may have to reveal Dracozolt. But then that means that he might not go with Corviknight, seeing that I've got Gravity and Dracozolt. This should be right. And then he can't win the 3-move from Calder. If he wakes up, he may not even KO the Excadrill. He'll put it in that Punch range, and he'll reveal the weakest policy, but... Oh, no, he's not reading the weakness policy. Then, Conkeldurr's probably so best. Because it's not Flame Orb. It wasn't Life Orb, was it? But I just not pay attention to a Life Orb. So that should be Assault Vest. That should be... But then what would the Raichu be? Because that had defensive investment. There's no way... Like, surely Rockfall takes it down to itself. If it's got no investment. If it survives this muddy water, it's definitely a Assault Vest. That doesn't tell me anything. It could still be a Assault Vest, but that was single target, so. Right, one more. One more game. Come on. Let's go to bed. Immediate lock-in to make it seem like I'm doing the same thing. those psychology things. But then, do you go next level and expect that because I put it in so quickly, that means that I am trying to bluff that I'm doing the same thing? So you know, there's so many levels. Milo took Max Flare into Excadrill. Worst case is Volt Switch himself Max Flare into Excadrill, but there's no way that's happening. Not with Follow Me potential. Just a little switch, that's fine. I think my Milotic gets KO'd here. Probably not, actually. But this is okay. Like, I'm pretty content with this. Like I said, best case is Max Flare into Excadrill, but I don't think that's happening. Yeah. We're living, it's good. Obvious max cut off, but yeah. Don't miss. Should have aerialized. Probably wasn't enough. I missed something. I missed my extra, but I hit the Raichu. That's okay. I'll take that. No weakness policy, but that's okay. It is a shame I missed it. The Earthquake would have been really good on Excadrill. It wouldn't have done much at all. He did. Oh, what a fool! Oh, hits as well. Nice. Nothing. Excellent. Aerial Ace KOs the Kelda. He doesn't have Protect on his Togekiss, please. He has Max Guard, but because he's weakness policy, that usually indicates the three attacks follow me. So just don't be Protect, please. I'm not going to Rock Slide, I'm just going to Iron Head. Don't have Protect. Yeah, Protect. Can I hit the Bolt Beat? Oh well. Probably doesn't have Heat Wave. Living. Oh, by the way, I have EV for this, so I should live. My EVs are perfect! Shame I didn't do that into the Corviknight, that was a bit of a waste. Brave Bird shouldn't be enough. Even if it is, I can still maybe 1v1. Well, it's probably still Lumberry though. Oh, I'm plus 4 attack actually. He's only plus 2 defense. No, follow me is better. Two Rock Slides. I see this as a 50-50 between Roost and... I think he's going to Roost. Ah, oh, he got me. But now he has to Roost. Very iron-headed. Good play, good play. Should've just muddy watered. That was good play. That's annoying, because now I'm gonna have to... I'm gonna have to play another game. Now he has to roost, right? See, I can afford to... I don't think I can afford to coil here. No, I can't, because if he Brave Birds, he KOs himself. Is this going to two-shot the second coil? It's going to be so close. It's going to be so close. But I've got lefties instead of Marangle, which is good. Come on. Good, good. My EVs are good. Ooh, I think my Milotic can do it. This turn is muddy water. Because if he Brave Birds, he puts himself in range. And this means he only has one chance to crit. That's fine. That was a chance to crit. But I think he wins now. So that did not KO. And I get my own accuracy drop. That is a very annoying crit. Like, I did call it into existence, but that is annoying. Like, to be fair, I should have probably recovered. But that is annoying. That is very annoying. That is unfortunate. I probably should have recovered, but there you go. Pretty sure it doesn't have Max Flare. We haven't found out if he was alone before the night. I'm still assuming he is. Is Clefable faster? Like, it won't matter if he fakes out, but like, I'm still fine with this. It's a shame I didn't get into my low tick to keep Clefable, but I get an SD. Yeah, he's a slow ball tonight. Very good. Shame I didn't coil. Oh, he still spikes, so I can coil next turn, that's fine. This time Milotic is actually going to 1v1 this Corviknight. And Excadrill is going to take care of the Raichu and the Togekiss. Playing extra safe. So I think he's gonna airstream this turn. Oh, okay. I see you. This is how we're gonna do it. Glad I recovered, I think that's better. As long as I get it off. This turn I coil. So I'm going to be plus 3 defense, so... It doesn't matter if the Tokus protects, I'll just... Iron Head it next turn, and then I will 1v3 this... Oh, 3v1 this Corviknight, more like... My obvious protect, but I don't care. I don't need... I am in a position where I don't need to protect. That did loads. I'm not rock sliding, I'm not missing the Tokus. Because I'm plus defenses on my Milotic and Excadrill, and he can't really hit the Excadrill, so I can Swords Dance plus 6 if I want. Was his play. I'm playing it in my second coil. This is starting to get unreasonable. Am I only plus 4? Yeah. And what's he? So yeah, he will bulk out one more time. Sam's gonna run out though, so I'm not gonna be able to flinch him, which is a bit of a shame. Let's try and find out. Pretty sure he was Lumberry. Oh, big damage. Oh, even bigger damage. Alright, land the Hypnosis. Is he Lumberry? He was indeed Lumberry. But now I just need to hit one more Hypnosis. Alright, Power Flinch. Oh, missed. Oh, but got the hypnosis, let's go. I love my low tick extra heals so much. Rock Slide this turn. It doesn't matter if he wakes up this turn. Yeah, yeah, high horsepower would be silly. When the odds are in my favor for him to stay asleep, Rock Slide is better. Now just break through Milotic, finish this. I wanted a nice and quick game, and then we got this long, drawn out three game best of three. At least I'm in top cut. You know, a top cut. That's something. I get to go to bed. I just need to forfeit my last round. So, yeah. Top Gun. Very happy. Thanks for watching.